Hello everyone, welcome to Lumina Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you this Maniology Crystal Galaxy Stacking Starter Kit. I went ahead and bought it because I kept seeing reviews for it, and then I saw like a little discount. So honestly, before I start, I should like put out a little disclaimer. I don't really stamp. I used to stamp a lot when I used regular nail polish, but since I stopped using that regular nail polish, I really am not good at stamping. So I did already open this and try to use it a couple times so that I could get more familiar with it, and also that way so I can give like a better review or opinion. So this is the box it came in. It was sort of, well, it was taped here. On the back we have like the steps with apply stamping art polish over your selected design on the nail stamping plate. Hold your scraper card at a 45 degree angle. Gently scrape excess polish off the design toward the edge. Move quickly using the squishy part of your stamper. Pick up the image with a light rolling motion. With the design transferred to the stamper, place the design onto your nail bed using a smooth rolling motion. Seal your design with our smudge-free top coat. So, basically, that's it. It is at maniology.com. I did buy this. Once again, I don't know if I said that I bought this. So it is not, it was not given to me. So we have this little Maniology starter kit stamping guide. It's like basically all the same information with like how to stamp, then can I stamp over any base? Why is the pattern incomplete or partially picked up? My design is perfect, but I smudged after I applied the top coat, and then, you know, just general information. So it comes with a little scraper card so that you can actually scrape it. Here's the plate. Really, it's not like too dirty. I will clean it off so that it is a little cleaner for you. Let me see. I know sometimes it can be blinding to show it on camera, so yeah, you see, so basically that is it. It came with, they're so hard to get out. It came with this. It is the nail polish and the clear coat, and you open it up like that, and then the little stamping jelly. It is a very soft jelly, so it's probably the softest one I've had. So I'm gonna get everything ready and I'll be right back. Okay, so ignore the mess because I was just testing some things out right now because I know a truth about me. So I have these three nails. They're all gel polish. They're just gel polish because that's what I have access to. Like I was saying, I really got rid of all my nail polishes, so I don't actually have any nail polishes other than a white, a black, and like a clear coat. So we're going to start off with this, the colors that they sent, or the color that they sent, I should say. It's just this with the top coat. So once again, before we start, like, just putting it out there, I am not good at stamping. So just saying, I'm really not good at it. So I have everything prepped, which is, that's part of why there's sort of a mess going on here. It is that because I was testing things out. So we're going to start off with this design right here, and we're going to see if I can oops, sorry about that. We're going to see if I can pick that one up. So we're going to swipe, 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 right? Oops, making a mess. And one thing I will say about gel that I'm not like super fond of is the waste. There's a, or not gel, stamping, is that waste. And you see, that is exactly why I don't like stamping, because I really suck at stamping. So I'm gonna try that again. Stamping seems like it's just, it's one of those things where I feel like it just takes so much product and it's like repetitive, it's just, and I'm not a wasteful person, so I think for me it's pretty difficult because I'm already seeing it as like so much is being thrown out. Like you have to scrape off so much product in order to sort of get that design, right? So you spread that whole thing and then you wipe it off and look at that. It's like so much. And then swipe it and it sort of came out wrong, but let's go ahead and stamp. So you see, I'm not very good at stamping. I mean, really, it's like, you guys can be honest, I'm not good at stamping. So we'll try that with something else. We'll try it with like this design right here. And then we'll go, you pick up, yeah. Okay, that looks okay. I don't know where these came from. We can get those off later, so it's fine. Okay, so that's not coming out bad. The good thing is like, because I'm using gel as the base, I can just like quickly wipe it right off. Oops, sorry. So let's see. Oh, I should really clean that one. Okay, so. Can you see that? It came out nice. So what I would say mainly with Maniology so far is, you have to press pretty lightly when you're scraping off the excess. That seems to be the major key to this, is just scraping really lightly. Like, don't dig into that polish. And I guess the firmness doesn't really seem to impact the stamp. So whether you press hard or soft, it doesn't really seem to change. But because I was testing, I wanted to see if I can do this better with just plain old nail polish. Because back in the day when I used to stamp, I used to just use plain nail polish. So I have this Simple Colors in Snow Me White. And we're just going to do the same thing. So much waste, though. It's sort of heartbreaking. Okay, so we're gonna roll. Oh, that picked up really nice. Let's see if I can use this over the top. Oh, look at that. That one came out pretty nice. So regular nail polish seems to work fine. Majorly no biggie, no difference. Anything, I would probably say that nail polish probably came out this a little better than the Maniology polish. But seems like here, like, where's my light roller? Seems like just basically it's a learning curve. I really don't stamp enough to say much. I can't really be a fair judge in this situation because I don't use a lot of nail polish. So plates are easy to clean. You just use a little isopropyl alcohol or a little acetone and and it's almost like good as new. So okay, I will test out the top coat and see how that works out. Seems like a nice top coat. Nice and glossy. I don't see any smudging going on with the stamping gel, so that's pretty good. So I'll give this time to dry and then I will be right back. Okay, so we're gonna finish up this little unboxing slash review, and I will say the top coat dries incredibly fast. Like, it hasn't even been a minute and this is dry. Like, this is amazing. So it is a glossy top coat, and it seems to dry really well. You might want two coats just to make sure it's extra smooth, because this one did come out a little bumpy. So I would say great top coat, good stamping plate, great stamper. It all seems like it's pretty nice. It's pretty good. If you're more into stamping, I think it's a good purchase. If you're really willing to invest that amount in it, then definitely I would say go for it. If you're not really good at stamping, you might want to just postpone a purchase, or see if you can maybe like buy it used and on like Mercari or something, or like eBay. See if you can buy one that's already been used and test it out for yourself rather than paying that full price. I do know that Maniology has a lot of sales, and there are a lot of YouTubers that have like special codes, so you can get a discount by checking out those other YouTubers. So mainly I would say, for me personally, I probably won't buy another stamping set, only because I just use gel, and unless I could figure out how to get that gel to not seize up once I've got it on the stamper, I just don't really think I'll use this a lot. But I do love the designs. Absolutely beautiful. If you love like galaxies and stuff, stars and moons, crystals, super perfect set. So overall, I'd say if you like stamping, this is fantastic. You can use regular polish. It seems to work perfectly fine. I haven't encountered an issue with it. If you're like me and you're maybe a little slower when it comes to stamping, I would practice with a regular polish so that you get that slower dry time rather than using theirs to start, because it seems like their polish in particular dries incredibly fast, so you might not get as much play time as you would with a traditional polish. Like I said, like, I used this cheap Sinful Colors. This was like $2 or so at the store. Very inexpensive. So that would be a great way to practice with this before you get really good at it. Overall, good quality, a very, very nice stamper. Like, of all the stampers I've had, this is probably the best. Like, the jelly texture of it, it just really forms well to the nail. So can't say enough about that one. So mainly, that's really my review. As somebody who actually purchased this with their own money, it isn't a bad set. It is very, very nice. If you're interested in, let me see if I can get this to focus there. If you're interested in stamping, it seems like a great set, as I said. But personally, I just don't see it because I just don't stamp enough. I do love this pattern right here. This little design is just so cute. So hope that was helpful for all of you. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day. And bye-bye.